When most people think of archaeology, they see a checkerboard excavation with people carefully digging into the ground with shovels and trowels. Recording and excavating archaeological sites are the primary means to recover evidence of people in ancient Iowa. Today, however, archaeologists also use highly sophisticated methods to study the past in ways that minimize disturbance of the ground and prevent damage to important finds. Non-invasive, non-destructive archaeology is important because sites are a vanishing resource that must be conserved. Over the past century, thousands of sites in Iowa have been lost to the plow, the bulldozer, natural erosion, and looters. Ancient burial sites in Iowa are protected by state law and must be preserved whenever possible. Iowa has thousands of archaeological sites, some as old as the last ice age, others as recent as the last century. While many sites lie deeply buried beneath Iowa soils, others have left visible impressions on the surface of the modern landscape. Earthen mounds like these in Louisa County mark the location of prehistoric cemeteries. A stone dam across the Iowa River represents a former fish trap. Buried ditches outline circular depressions, the location of former houses, and all that remains of a 1,000-year-old farming hamlet in northwestern Iowa. Archaeology is the principal way to learn about people of the ancient past. Traditional methods, such as surface survey and excavation, are still crucial in discovering and recovering archaeological remains. Artifacts found on the surface are the primary clues to the presence of an archaeological site. Soil color changes can indicate buried sites. However, new techniques continue to improve the ways archaeologists find and map ancient sites and study their contents. Remote sensing refers to the examination of archaeological features from a distance, typically from the air. Archaeologists have been using remote sensing since before World War I. Unusual features seen at low altitude and recorded on photographs are mapped and interpreted for their archaeological significance. In this winter photograph, buried ditches surrounding the Double Ditch Village in O'Brien County stand out markedly in the unplowed portion of the site. Plowing has removed all traces of the ditch in the field to the east. Not far from Double Ditch, lines of earthen ridges mark the location of prehistoric garden rows. Computer enhancement of aerial photographs is now a part of remote sensing. Enhancing old photos of the Turkey River Mound group in Clayton County improved their sharpness and contrast, allowing detection of 7 previously unrecorded features. The features seen here as linear rows of depressions can now be examined to determine if they are ancient mounds. Settlers in the 1840s described an octagonal earthwork adjacent to the 2,000-year-old Middle Woodland Mounds at Toolsboro in Louisa County. Despite 150 years of plowing, aerial photos suggest that remnants of the earthwork may still lie buried beneath the surface. Computer enhancement of the air photos and eventual test excavation could verify the identity of this ancient construction. Recording and mapping of archaeological sites are also aided by GPS and GIS. With GPS, or global positioning systems, a small unit receives multiple satellite signals and determines the user's location. When all goes well, a site's position can be mapped to a meter or less. At the 1,000-year-old Cowan site in Woodbury County, GPS was used to map the location of houses and features such as storage pits and hearths. Over 18,000 archaeological sites have been recorded in Iowa. Traditionally, their locations were recorded by hand on United States Geological Survey maps. Site forms, survey and excavation reports, and photographs make up the database of information on each of these sites. Archaeologists are now converting the site locations from traditional maps to digital form using GIS or geographical information systems. The digitized maps can then be linked to related databases. GIS helps to combine archaeological data with other types of geographical information, such as landforms and soils. By overlaying geomorphological maps with site maps, archaeologists can predict where buried sites might be found, and thus aid in their discovery and preservation. Using GIS, archaeologists have generated three-dimensional maps showing the topographic location of sites in the Upper Iowa River Valley in Alamakee County. Archaeological sites appear as light blue ponds against the topography. Such maps illustrate the relationship of ancient settlements to other features of the natural landscape. For decades, archaeologists have used many forms of probing and digging to detect and evaluate buried remains. Soil probes, mechanical augers, and various coring devices provide a glimpse of what might lie below the surface of a site while creating minimal damage. Today, the high cost of digging and the need to protect and preserve archaeological sites, such as ancient cemeteries, mean that excavation may be limited or even prohibited. As a result, Iowa archaeologists are using non-destructive geophysical survey techniques to guide research and to learn more about sites prior to or instead of excavation. Most of these techniques involve the use of instruments which work in one of two ways. Either they measure distortions of the Earth's magnetic field created by buried features such as hearths or pits, or they pass various kinds of energy through the ground in order to detect such features. Buried materials often produce slight distortions of the Earth's magnetic field. These distortions appear as anomalies detectable with an instrument known as a magnetometer or gradiometer. After establishing a grid at a site, the archaeologist passes the magnetometer over the surface, obtaining measurements at regular intervals. The data are transferred to a portable computer, and a map is produced which displays the locations of the anomalies. Then the grid is moved to another part of the site, and the process is repeated. Magnetic surveys have located ancient mounds even after they were plowed flat. The ability of material to conduct or resist an electrical current is the basis for conductivity and resistivity surveys. Buried materials resist or conduct electricity generally as a consequence of their moisture content. Buried foundations and stone walls may be more resistant to an electrical current, while ditches, pits, and metals more easily conduct. Magnetometer and conductivity surveys were recently used at the Plum Grove Historic Site in Johnson County, the residence of Robert Lucas, first governor of the territory of Iowa. Excavations conducted at Plum Grove since 1974 have revealed the remains of features and artifacts used by the Lucas family and later residents. Together with documentary evidence, this research makes it possible to reconstruct 19th century lifestyles and to trace the changes in Plum Grove over the century it was occupied. The results of the geophysical survey will help guide future research, interpretation, and planning at Plum Grove. Effigy Mounds National Monument, overlooking the Mississippi River in northeast Iowa, contains over 100 prehistoric mounds. Because burials are off-limits to excavation, non-invasive study is one of the best ways to research this important property. In addition to magnetometer and resistivity surveys, archaeologists recently undertook a ground-penetrating radar survey of some of the mounds. This method sends low-frequency electromagnetic pulses, radio waves, into the ground. As the signals encounter subsurface features and other soil changes, they are reflected back and monitored by a receiving antenna. The readings are fed into a computer and, when analyzed, produce a three-dimensional view of what lies beneath the surface. In this way, it is possible to locate buried features without ever disturbing the mound itself. In addition to new techniques of site detection and recording, Iowa archaeologists also use sophisticated methods to identify and study recovered materials like these charred seeds. The scanning electron microscope, or SEM, produces a high-resolution three-dimensional image of tiny objects. Beams of electrons scan the object's surface, freeing weaker electrons that are detected by a special sensor. A computer transfers this image to a screen. The SEM helps archaeologists examine bone and stone tools for signs of wear and use, and helps identify seeds and pollen of ancient plants. Materials such as stone, clay, and certain metals possess a distinctive geochemical signature, or fingerprint, depending on their source of origin. The SEM microprobe detector measures the X-ray energies of different elements making up this fingerprint. Once its elemental signature is known, the source of the material can often be determined. In the case of artifacts such as the beautiful stone pipes and copper axes and pins recovered decades ago from sites like the mounds at Toolsboro, non-destructive analysis helps expand our knowledge of these important finds. State-of-the-art methods for recording, mapping, and analyzing archaeological remains enhance traditional methods. They also allow us to learn more about ancient peoples while minimizing damage to archaeological sites and artifacts. This helps keep the sites intact for more detailed study in the future. It also helps preserve sites so the public can visit and appreciate them. Iowa Archaeology, using modern methods to conserve the past.